is 30% higher than the U.S. when adjusted for population. Elizabeth Palmer went to Stockholm. See what happened.
The Stockholm vibe is real. Stores and restaurants have stayed open throughout the pandemic, and so have primary and middle school. How nervous are you? Limiting gatherings of over 50 would control the infection, along with Swedish common sense.
So you are social distancing?
As far as I can. It's not always that easy, but I try.
You don't wear masks?
No, we don't wear a mask. We haven't. No, we haven't.
And neither do most people.
I'm wearing my mask, but nobody else is.
But there's no doubt that Sweden's lockdown light has cost lives. And one of them belonged to Helen Glickman's 80-year-old father, Jan.
He was squeezing my hand when I was talking to him, but on Wednesday he was...
He didn't know you were there.
I think he...
When Jan tested positive for COVID, the care home didn't send him to the hospital, but gave him morphine. And in days, he was dead.
Have you lost faith in your government?
Yes, of course. I've lost faith in the government.
With summer here, Sweden's outbreak is finally slowing from a peak of more than 100 deaths a day to the low teens. But in a couple of months, people will head back indoors where the virus could easily explode again. But so far, there's no sign the authorities are changing course. And that alarms epidemiologist Nelle Brusseles.
If there is one country in Europe where there will be a second peak, it will be most likely Sweden, because they're still not doing that much to really stop it.
Last month, Sweden's Prime Minister announced an inquiry into the handling of the COVID outbreak as polls began to show that public confidence was dropping. For CBS This Morning, I'm Elizabeth Palmer in Stockholm.